And we're back for another episode. In this episode, we're going to be doing the dungeon The Burn, which is part of the 4.4 story.
Make ready, friends! We are come to the burn!
Make sure we have shield off up. Okay, so I've never done this before, so let's take a look. And I also picked up from the market board a free 80 gear set. Interesting music. Never really forget the rotations, do you? That's one thing I didn't check, actually. Ah. I was told you can actually use, like, 10 now. So I guess I can use them all. Double flash. The advantage as well that because I'm completely up to date, the mods are not melting my health. There has been patches where I've gone into the story mode exactly at the item level requirement, and then it's been a real struggle. Annoyed people with my choice of voice for Mithrie, because when she's doing her attacks, she's like, ooh, ah, ooh, and the whole party can hear it as well. Okay, so let's keep going. I guess I don't really care about falling rocks because it doesn't mean anything. Next.
Hey,
going. There's another one. Predictable. Oh. I did find it funny that they kept adding in all these gated features and all the dungeons, just because back in the old days you could pull like half the instance and just AoE it down. So they've gated everything now, so you can't do that anymore. If you get targeted, hide behind the crystal. If big AoE comes, hide as well. Okay. Right. Let's do this. So I'll rotate my cooldowns. Fail. I'm the tank, who cares? $23k clemency. Lol. That's why I like Paladin. You can heal yourself. What I've always wondered in these games is, like, given it's a bottomless pit right there, like, should you be able to just fall to your death rather than there being invisible walls to protect you? Would it make it more or less fun? Too slow. Oh well. I don't mind throwing the occasional heal or whatever, if it makes the healer's life a lot easier, then why not? Done. Easy. Okay, so what did we get? 355 gear, don't need it. Don't need it. I know people say always to greed. Then just sell them to the grand company, but I don't really do that. Okay, let's go, let's go. Interesting. Magitek. I do enjoy Paladin the most, to be honest, out of the tanks. I mean, Warrior was fun to play for a while, but I just like the damage mitigation on Paladin. Obviously, the advantage is when you get your tank gear, you can share it with all your tanks. So now that I've spent all these millions on gear for my Paladin, if I just pick up the Warrior weapon, and I've also got a tanking set as well for Warrior. If I level up Dark Knight, that'll be fully geared as well. Now, given that Warriors have got Defiance, it makes me wonder if I'll have like 80 plus K health as a Warrior with the same gear on. Let's seal to save time. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's rotate some cooldowns. Do one more flash for good luck. Oh, that's annoying. Okay, anything I need to know about this one? I wonder. Let's see, when he runs off the side is fine with damage droid only, safe space. Okay. Let's do it then. It clearly marks which one is not going to work. That makes sense. Much. Okay. So, like, don't panic. Okay, any more loot? Nope. I mean, there's not going to be any loot, so just pass it all. I wish there was a pass all button in this game. Wow. That's pretty. That's what I was saying before, that this is what I want in MMOs, is to just be like, you know, look at that. I wonder if that was actually two pulls at once. I do have a feeling if I was still wearing my previous gear set that I would be struggling here. Take some cooldowns. Liking the amount of direct hit. You see, I'm getting those bigger hits quite often. It's like in some cases several times in a row even. The first one. Okay. Okay. I mean, this dungeon is pretty. I do like it. right. Sorry. When the boss turns into the fog, do not attack him. Even if it's possible, you'll get petrified. Attack the dragon's head, which will appear. Okay. Got it. Makes sense. Mechanic we have seen many times before. Pew, That was fun. I like that. Okay, so thank you, team. Right, let's see what the end cutscene is for this dungeon.
Between contending with bloodthirsty beasts and sand in my every conceivable place, oh. I had begun to despair of finding you again.
Do you recognize the crashed ship over yonder?
Yes, I do.
Alizé and I briefly inspected it. It is the vessel that bore Master Alfano away.
But there was no sign of him, nor of Maxima and his people.
War Machina. It would seem they were involved in a struggle. There may be clues. We should split up and search the area.
Cool. Nod.
These were no ordinary soldiers. Over here! The insignia on this man's uniform identifies him as one of the Emperor's personal guard.
Hand-picked soldiers, answering only to the royal family.
That would explain why all the casualties are Garlean. They were fighting their own.
You're saying the Emperor was behind all this? That Alfano is his prisoner?
Don't know yet. Alfano is fine, I'm sure of it. It's rational. We don't know yet.
Aye, we must not jump to conclusions. Besides, Alfano is more than capable of looking after himself, is he not?
I suggest we return to Doma to consider our options. Whatever happened here, Master Alfano is long gone, and any subsequent search may safely be left in the hands of the Shinobi.
Where in the world are you, brother? If you die on me, I will never let you hear the end of it.
If you die, I'll kill you. Cool. Let's just finish off this quest. So, well, that was a decidedly uneventful journey. I almost found myself hoping for a sandstorm. Joking aside, I'd say our birds are due a good brush down and a treat or two, wouldn't you? Yep. So that's it. So anyway, guys, that's it for this episode. Thank you for watching, and as always, goodbye from me and goodbye from Mithrie. Bye, guys.